The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 1st chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 21st, 1975, in Melbourne, Australia.
So, we have discussed the last 2 days, what is the aim of life? So, this whole Krishna consciousness movement is diverting the aim of life. There are 2 ways. Our present position, the aim of life is sense gratification. Janamaithunadigrahamedisukhammitucham. Material life means sense gratification, as much as possible. And the central point of sense gratification is sex life. Janamaithunadi. Maithun means sexual intercourse. This is the machine to keep the living entity bound up under the condition of material nature. We are conditioned by the material nature. We are thinking we are free. We are not free. That is not the fact. Therefore, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that you are thinking that you are free, whatever you like and do, enjoy sense gratification, but under condition. You are not free. So, there are different grades of sense gratification, but the point is sense gratification. The cats and dogs, the animals, they are also satisfying their senses, and the human being also engaged in the same business. The cats and dogs, they are eating to their taste. The human being is also eating to their taste. The standard may be different, but the taste is the same. Either you have sex intercourse with beautiful wife or husband, or a sex intercourse between the she dog and he dog, the enjoyment is the same. Just like if you have got a palatable food, either you put it into a golden pot or if you put it into an iron pot, the taste is the same. The taste is not different. One may think that I am eating in golden pot, therefore I am advanced. But a learned man will say that whether you have changed the taste, either you drink something palatable in a golden pot or in iron pot or paper pot, the taste is the same. So this is called pravritti marga. Pravritti marga means advancing in sense gratification. So there are different grades. From the animal life, we come to human life, and if we like, we can go to the higher planetary system, janalok, mahalok, tapalok. There are many planetary systems above the sun. We have already discussed, above the sun, the moon planet is above the sun. The moon planet is not so near. So, Krishna says that even if you go to the highest planetary system, Brahmalok, that is, many thousands of years you can live and gratify your senses to higher standard than in this. Suppose you are drinking here in golden pot, there you will get in diamond pot. That will be the change. Not that the taste will change. The taste is same. The dog's pot or man's pot or demigod's pot within the material world, the taste is the same. And ultimately, you have to die. That's all. That you cannot stop. Nobody wants to die. He wants to enjoy life perpetually. Now the scientists are trying to live more years. So, what is the use of living more years? The Shastra says, Tarava kingna jivanti. The trees, they live for 5,000 years or more than that. Do they not live long years? So sane man will think that what is the use of living for 500 or 5,000 years standing in one place? So this is not advancement. The advancement is that, as Krishna says, that to solve the problem of birth, death, old age and disease. That is advancement. Krishna says therefore that abrahma bhuvana lokan punaravartin arjuna. Even if you go to the moon planet, even if you go to the topmost planet, which is called Brahmaloka, there you can live for many millions of years, but you have to die. As you have to die here, as the cat dies, dog dies, we human beings, we also die, the demigods, they also die, the Brahma will also die. Nobody can save himself from death. Death, birth, death, old age and disease. We have already discussed that we, living beings, soul, we are eternal. We are eternal, we are simply changing the body, one body to another. In this way, material life means you can live for 1 minute or 1 hour or 100 years or millions of years. You get a particular type of body and according to that body you live, and then you have to die. Krishna says that abrahma bhura lokan punaravartin arjuna. Even if you go to the topmost planet, you can live for long, long years, but you'll have to die and again come to this earthly planet and again begin your life. This is going on. So how it is going on? Pravritti marga. I want to enjoy sense gratification. This is the basic principle. So this Krishna consciousness movement means that back to home, back to Godhead. Not to make proceed or progress towards birth, death, old age and disease, but make progress towards no birth, no death, no old age, no disease. That is Krishna consciousness. That is called Nivitti Marga. Nivitti Marga. Nivitti means stop this type of progress. So there are indications in the Shastra that how to make progress towards the goal of Nivitti Marga. That is stated, Mahaseva Dharam Ahut Vimukte. If you associate with devotees, Mahatma, great soul. Who is great soul? Great soul means who has understood God. He is great soul. That he is called Mahatma. That is stated, Mahatmanustumang Pratha Devi Prakriti Masrita Vajanti Ananda Manusu. Mahatma means he is not under the condition of this material nature. He is under the protection of the spiritual nature. He is Mahatma. You have to live under somebody. That is our position. You cannot say that I am not living under somebody, I am independent. No, that is not possible. Nobody can say. Can anybody say that I am independent? No. Because our constitutional position is that, to serve. Either I serve my family, or serve my community, or serve my nation, or serve my government. In this way go on increasing. But your position is to serve. You here will find therefore that the so-called master is also servant. Just like President Nixon. He was elected the master president, but actually he was the servant of the popular vote. As soon as he became unpopular, he was immediately dismissed. So, the president of a big state is the position that he is a servant. How you are not a servant? That is our nature. So people are engaged in service. Generally. Generally that is the law. If one hasn't got to serve anybody, no family, no children, no wife, then he keeps a dog to serve him. Is it not a fact? I've seen in the Western countries old man who has no family, his whole day is keeping a dog and seeing the television. Because nature is to serve. That you cannot. Therefore, pravritti marga means that we are trying to become false master, sense gratification. Actually, we are the servant of the senses. We are not master. When you become master of the senses, then this title is given, Goswami, Swami. Swami means master. Master means master of your senses. Now we are being dictated by the senses. You do this, we do that. So our master is the senses, and the senses are six kinds of senses. Kama, kamadina, lusty desires, lobha, greediness, and moha, illusion, kama, krodha, anger, mind. Mind is dictating something, I am serving. Yes, sir, I'll do it. This is our position. Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, masajya, in this way. So, by good association, by saintly man's association, that is recommended. Mahaseva dharam ahut vimukti. Mahaseva. This human life is meant for rectification. We are serving somebody and you are not happy. We have got very good example in our country, in many other countries. Just like our Mahatma Gandhi. He served his country very well. But the result was that his countrymen killed him. This is the result of our service. Nobody will appreciate. We are serving our family. The wife is not satisfied. He divorces the husband. The son is not satisfied. He goes out of home. To just analyze that we are serving to our best capacity, but nobody is satisfied. This is our position. Kamadinam kotidhana kotidha palita dunnidesa. Actually, we are serving our senses. I love my wife because she satisfies my senses. I love my husband because he satisfies my senses. Actually, you are servant of our senses. As soon as the sense gratification is disturbed, then, no, I am not going to serve. Or I am not satisfied with your service, you go away, I go away. This is our position. The senses are there. So one who is associating with the devotees men, who is engaged in the service of the Lord. He is not engaged in the service of the senses. That is devotee. Devotion. The definition of devotion is given in the Shastra. Sarvopadhi vininmuktam tatparatena nirmalam rishikena rishikesa sevanam bhaktiruchyate. Sarva upadhi vininmuktam. Upadhi means designation. I am spirit soul, but because I have accidentally or my result and action of my past karma, I am thinking I am Indian, somebody is thinking I am American. So this is the designation of the soul. I am neither Indian nor somebody is American, somebody is Australian. We are living soul, aham brahmasmi. That is my position. But being designated in a different way, I have become a servant of that designation. So, bhakti means nivitti marga, to become free from all these designations. That is called bhakti. The definition of mukti or liberation or becoming free from the designation is given in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Mukti hitva anatha rupam sarupena avasthiti. Mukti means when we give up the service in designation and we are situated in our original constitution position, that is called mukti, liberation or salvation, whatever you like. Mukti hitva anatha rupam sarupena, in my own constitution. What is my own constitution position? I am eternal servant of God, Krishna. This is my position. So, when we give up all this designation service and engage myself in the real service of the real master, that is called mukti, liberation. So this Krishna consciousness movement is trying to educate men that after all you are servant, you have to serve somebody. You are now serving your senses. Now just divert your service to Krishna or God and you will be happy. That's all. The service constitution position will not change. That is my position. In Bengali there is a proverb, dheki shagge gelo dhan bhange. The dheki, that's a wooden machine for husking grain. So, I do not know whether it is used in your country. It is a big, it is paddled by the legs and the grains are taken away, the skin. So if this dheki, this machine is sent to heavenly planet, what will do? The same business. Dug, dug, dug. So either you go to the heavenly planet, or you remain here, or you remain in animal kingdom, even the trees, they are standing, they are giving service. They are giving you fruits, they are giving you flowers. And if you want his service by the wood, by the body you cut, it will not protest. All right. You take my body. So that is the way to understand that we must render service to somebody higher. So why not go to the Supreme, the Great, God is great, and render service. This is Krishna consciousness. Then we'll be happy. You can go on giving service in this material world, under so many designations, but you will never be happy, and the person to whom you are giving service, he will be not happy. This is material world. Try to understand. Therefore, one devotee, he says, Tama dinam katidha na palita dunnidesa tesa namayina karuna jata natrpa nopasanti sampratam labdha buddhi samayata nijinkumam atvadasi. This is called good sense. The purpose of this verse is, my dear Lord, I have served my senses in the form of lusty desires and anger and so many things, calm, crude, lobe, greediness, and my senses are, means these things. So, I have served lifelong, but neither they are satisfied, neither I am satisfied. These are, and they are not merciful. I have served them up to the age of 80 years, but still they want service from me. If I want to retire, they will not agree. If somebody says to his wife, then I have served so much in the family, now let me go to the Krishna conscious temple, I serve there. The wife will disagree. No. What service you have got? You have got duty, this duty. So it will never end. Even if you give lifelong service, just like I have given the example, Gandhi gave lifelong service according to his own. Hitler gave lifelong service. Napoleon gave lifelong service. But their ultimate end was very, very regrettable. Nobody realized his service. He was punished. This is material world. We have to understand very clearly, and we have to take lesson from this verse that we may go on serving our lusty desire, greediness, anger, and so on, but we'll never come to the end and become happy. When one comes to the point that I have rendered service in so many ways, so neither I am happy nor the person to whom I have served, they are happy. Then what is the remedy? That is discussed in the Vedanta Sutra philosophy. Athāto brahma jignyāsa. Now inquire about your real master, Brahma, or the Supreme, the Great, the Absolute. That is required. So, we should be prepared like that, that we have served our propensities, defined propensities, lusty desire, greediness, anger, calm, crowd, lobe, moho. Moho means illusion. I am doing something wrong and I am thinking it is all right. This is called illusion, moho. Matsarja. Matsarja means envious, to become envious. Every one of us, either individually or socially or community-wise or nationally, we are all envious. The Russians, they are envious of the American, and the Americans, they are envious of the Russians. Similarly, everyone. That is the nature. So we are serving all these propensities. Now, this is called pravritti marga. Progress towards sense gratification in different ways. And if we stop that and make progress to our real self-realization, real happiness, that is called nibbitti marga. this morning I was talking with one gentleman. He is in charge of the social welfare. So when I propose that our nibbitti marga we recommend these processes. No illicit sex, no meat eating, no intoxication, and no gambling. Beginning. So he was not satisfied. He says that why you stop illicit sex, we get pleasure. So this is the understanding of the modern civilization. He is risking his life by all these processes. But if we request that stop this process, come to Krishna consciousness, they will not agree. That is the difficulty. Therefore, this line of action, Nivritti Marga, it is little difficult, but it is very easy. If one understands the philosophy, what is the meaning of Pravritti Marga and what is the meaning of Nivritti Marga, and if he is sane man, then he will accept, yes. Just like if you go to a physician and you are suffering from a disease, being, say, just like nowadays there is prominent alcoholic treatment. People are too much addicted to alcohol, and there are so many departmental treatment, even for the priest also. I have seen one in a paper that there in America there is a hospital where especially the priestly class drunkard they are treated. And 5,000 patients are there. So if the physician says, no, no, you give up your drinking habit, then you will be angry. Now how will you be treated? That is the only medicine that you give up. It is not very difficult thing. Nobody learns drinking from the birth. Now even one has learned drinking. Now all our students, you see, practically, they are young men. They are not old men. Their senses are still strong, but they have given up. They have given up. They have given up illicit sex. They have given up intoxication. They do not take even tea, do not smoke cigarette. Neither they go to cinema. What to speak of going to other places? It is possible. But if we give up all these things, then our beginning to the Nivritti Marga, our progress towards back to home, back to Godhead, that is beginning. So, if we accept the process, it is not difficult. So our life should be trend up in this way, Nivritti Marga. Then we can make process for going back to home, back to Godhead. First of all, we should understand that we are part and parcel of God. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, and actually it is fact. What is God? God means what we are doing, He is also doing. Because we are part and parcel, just like your son, your daughter. Yeah, they are your part and parcel of your body. So, what is the difference? They are also acting, you are also acting. Similarly, God, Krishna, is the Supreme Father. So far the activities are concerned, the same. But the difference is that God is great, we are small. That is the difference. God can create these so many planets, just like the sun globe. There are other globes also that are bigger than sun. Anyway, the sun is very big. So God has created this big globe. It means 1,400,000 times bigger than this earth, or even this earth, floating in the air. You can float a big 747 aeroplane also, floating in the air. But you cannot make a globe like sun and floating in the air. That is the difference between you and God. The creative power is there, because we are part and parcel. The value is there. Just like gold, mine, and a small particle of gold. The small particle will be called gold, and it has got some value, but not as good as the gold mine. This is the difference between God and ours. We should understand. So, if we give up this service to the senses and we engage ourselves in the service of the great, everyone wants to serve the great. That is natural. If one is serving ordinary mercantile firm, he is thinking of getting some service in the government office. That is very secure. So, if we seek our service to the supreme government, Krishna or God, then we'll be happy. That is Krishna consciousness movement. If you actually want to be happy, now you can see these boys, they are chanting, dancing. This is not artificial. Artificial dancing can be performed one day, 2 days, then finished. But they are doing 24 hours. How they are doing? Unless they are feeling some happiness, transcendental happiness, they are not fools, they are not uneducated, they are educated, they are coming from good family, but they have sacrificed everything and they are enjoying this Hare Krishna chanting and dancing. Unless they feel, even the girls, they are also dancing, but there is transcendental feeling of blissful life. Why? When one engages himself in the service of the Lord. This is the purpose. Very simple thing. And as soon as he will serve the designation, false service, he will spoil his time and will be under the condition of material nature. Material nature, we are all conditioned by material nature. Therefore, we are changing body from one body to another. Now, by the nature's own process, evolution, we have come to this human form of body, and we have got advanced consciousness, we have got direction, like Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Hari Guru Vaishnava Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavad Gita. Just our Mother Vishwasami said that we have got Krishna, we have got spiritual master, we have got the book, Bhagavad, we have got Gita. Now let us take advantage of it. These transcendental literature, we have taken much pain to translate them into English so that you can understand. We have got 50 books. So take advantage. It is not meant for the cats and dogs. It is meant for the human being. Not a particular class or nation, no. It is meant for all human beings. So take advantage of this knowledge, understand the philosophy of life, that I am eternal, na hannate hannamane sarire, I do not die after the annihilation of this body, I accept another body. We have got two bodies, this gross body and one subtle body. Just like you have got your coat, and within the coat there is sarv. Similarly, within this gross body, there is another subtle body. This gross body is made of the material elements, earth, water, air, fire, ether. These five elements, pancha. Pancha means five. Your body and my body. It is simply combination of these five material elements. This is the covering, coat. And within this, there is another body. What is that? Mind, intelligence and ego. So everyone knows that you have got mind, I have got mind. Everyone knows that you have got intelligence, I have got intelligence. And everyone is puffed up with some identification. I am this, I am that. these three conceptions. This is called subtle, subtle body. So we simply see the gross body, but we do not see the subtle body. When death takes place, that means this gross body is finished, then the subtle body is there. And the subtle body carries the soul to another gross body that we cannot see. Therefore, we do not understand how this spirit soul is migrating, transmigrating from one body to another. We do not see. Therefore, our seeing should be through knowledge, paschati jnana chakkhusa, not this gross seeing. Gross seeing is imperfect, it has no value. We know, we should inquire, now this gross body is finished, now what about the subtle body? So we have to understand from authoritative literature, the subtle body is working, just like when you sleep. Your gross body is not working, but the subtle body, the mind, intelligence and ego is working. Therefore you dream. Your subtle body is lying in some apartment and you have gone to the seaside by the mental body. So long this gross body is able, you again come and enter into this gross body. But when it is not workable, then you have to find out another gross body in the womb of a certain type of mother. This is the law of transmigration of the soul. That subtle body will be carried by the laws of nature. According to the work you have done to your whims, then a certain type of body will be offered to you. You will be forced to enter into the womb of a certain type of mother, and the mother will give you the body. That we have got everyone experience. In the mother body, after pregnancy, the body grows. Everyone knows it. The body grows, why? Because the soul has entered, and according to his karma, either good mother or bad mother. So you are growing the same body, or better body, a lower body, and when it is mature, then you come out, you begin again your life. That is called pravritti marga. In this way, we have to accept birth, death, old age. As soon as you get this material body, there is birth, and as soon as there is birth, there is death. And as soon as the body is there, it is growing old, it is suffering disease. So if you want to avoid these four things, that is specially pointed out by Krishna, janma mrityu jarabhyadi, you are solving your problems. Sir, what? How you have solved your birth, death, old age and disease? That is the question by Krishna. Have you solved? Then what is the use of solving problems? The real problem is there. But if you want to solve this real problem, then you should take up this nibbitti marga. Nibbitti marga means stop this way of sense gratification and take to Krishna consciousness. That is the way. If you continue your misbehavior, at the same time you want to cure your disease, that is not possible. That's like this alcoholic treatment. They go to the psychiatrist and so experienced doctor, if you do not give up this bad habit, then where is the question of treatment? Where is the question of treatment? That is called, that is explained in the Shastra, hastisnan. My example is very right. Hastisnan. Hasti means elephant. Elephant, they go into the water, in the lake, in the pond, and very nicely cleans their body. Body very nicely cleans, and after taking bath, as soon as it comes to the bank on the ground, he takes some dust and throws over the body. So, atonement, sometimes we make atonement. I have committed some sin, I go to church or go to temple, I make some atonement. Then after finishing that business, again I do that business. So, this kind of habit will not help you. You must try to stop the bad habit. That you can do when you are in the association of devotees. Otherwise it is not possible. Sometimes there is some disagreement that why one should not live outside the temple. But that is a little difficult because in the temple you get good association. Everyone is trying to become free from this bondage of life. So there is some inspiration. But if you live outside the temple, we are making this temple commodious so that people may come here and live and learn the art. But if you do not live, there is risk. Because sangha sanjayate kamo. If you live in certain association, drunkard association, then you will learn gradually how to drink. And if you live with the association of the devotees, then you will forget drinking, you will become devotee. So we are opening this center, giving chance everyone. There is no discrimination. It is not a religious system. It is a cultural institute. Don't take it as a religious. Religious is a kind of faith. You may accept that faith or not. Well, that is your discretion. But Krishna consciousness is not a kind of faith. It is a cultural institution. If you actually, you are serious that I must stop these inconveniences of birth, death and old age, then you must join this Krishna consciousness. That is my request. That is called Nivitti Marga. And gradually you will be elevated to the topmost position that you have no more attraction for these material things. That is possible. It is not that impossible. Simply, one has got to follow the process. The process is generally adu-sraddha. Adu-sraddha in the beginning, just like you have come here with some honor or some respect. That is called sraddha. Sraddha means faith. All right, let us go there. What is this Krishna conscious temple? This is the beginning. That you come. This is called sraddha. Then, if you like it, now here the people, they speak nicely from the book, then you come daily or weekly and associate with the adu sraddha tatu sadhu sangha. Sadhu sangha. This is the process. First of all, one must get a little faith and then associate with the devotee. Adu sadhya tatu sadhu sangha ata bhajana kriya. Then, by associating with the devotees, we learn that the devotees are worshipping the deity, they are chanting Hare Krishna mantra, and they are eating prasadam, and they are very happy. So why not engage me also in this way? So therefore, gradually, they come and offer, now sir, I shall join and initiate me. In this way you are doing. Adu sadhya tato sadhu sangha tato bhajana kriya ata anartha nivittishya. By execution of devotional service, whether you are making progress or not, that will be tested when anartha nivittishya. All the nonsense things which you have learned artificially, that will be finished. That is called anartha nivitti. Anartha vasamam sakshat bhakti yogam madat. We have created so many anarthas, unwanted things, not required for me as spirit soul, but artificially for this designation body. So, when one is engaged in actual devotional service, then the result will be anartha nivitti. same nimitta. Nimitta means finish. It is not that all our students were free from this alcoholic habit or meat eating or initiation. No, they were habituated. But because they have taken to the devotional service, this is all finished. Anartha nivitti syat. Then spiritual life begins. Tato nishtha. Yes, it is very nice. I shall continue. This is called nishtha, firm faith. The beginning was faith. And after anartha nivitti, firm faith. Yes, I shall continue. Tato nishtha, tato ruchi. How one can be firmly fixed up unless he has got a taste for it. He really says, yes, this time chanting and dancing is very nice. That is called release. Tatu manishtha, tatu ruchi, tatha asakti. Then he becomes attached. He cannot give it up. Asakti. Asakti means attachment. Just like we have got attachment for so many things. So these are the stages. Tatha asakti, tatu bhava, then ecstasy. And then you come to the platform of loving God. Now we are loving cats and dogs, we shall love God. This is the way. Thank you very much.
The gross body returns to the earth.
The gross body is finished. Gross body becomes ash, stool, or earth. Those who are burying the gross body, it becomes, after some time, earth. And those who are giving this body to be eaten by other animals, it becomes stool. And those who are burning this body, the body becomes ash. The gross body, there are three ultimate goals. Either to become ash, or stool, or earth.
His question was, is there a time when the subtle body ceases to exist?
Yes, that is liberation. When so long you are encircled by the subtle body, there is no question of liberation. Because the subtle body will take you to another gross body. When we are free from the subtle body, then we are liberated. We go back to home, back to God. Yes? I have already explained mind, intelligence and ego. This is subtle body. Everyone has got his mind. Everyone knows, but we cannot see. The intelligence, everyone has got intelligence, but we cannot see. Similarly, subtle body is invisible. Ghost means when the living entity remains in the subtle body, do not get another gross body. They are very sinful. They create disturbance. But we cannot see. That is ghost. Ghost means that those who are too much sinful, they do not get this gross body. They are punished with the position to remain in the subtle body. At least for some time. That is ghostly life. Therefore, you'll see ghostly haunted places, something is being done, but how it is being done, you do not see. Because you cannot see the subtle body. But you will see something is being carried in the air. It is not something being carried. It is being carried by the subtle body. But I have no eyes to see the subtle body. That is practical. I do not see your mind. But you have got your mind. You do not see my mind. You can see my mind by the action. That's all. The subtle body is there. Gross body, subtle body. Death means finishing of this gross body. And liberation means no more association with the subtle body. Only spiritual. That is called liberation.
How does one become free from that ghostly body?
Ghostly body means he has to suffer for some time, that is, you are put into prison. After your term is finished, then you get liberated. Similarly, a most sinful man is given this term, remain for some years, and a subtle body. Everything is like that. This is also, we have got this body, gross body, under certain condition. When that condition is finished, then I give up this body, I create another condition and I enter another body. This is very good. Yes?
He's saying that if we all reach Godhead in the end, why do we have to speed up the process? Why not we just let things take their natural course of events if everyone's going back to Godhead ultimately?
That is a good suggestion, but you wrought for the time being. Suppose you are going somewhere, walking, and somebody gives you opportunity, come in my car, why don't you take advantage of it? You will reach the destination by walking in 6,000 years. But if you get the opportunity in your country, it is good. There is staircase and there is elevator. So, if you want to go, then I shall go by the staircase and reach the upstairs at the end of the day when office will be finished. Then you can do that. But if you are intelligent, you shall take the advantage of the elevator within a minute to go there. That is intelligence. I am going, I shall reach at the end of the day when every office will be closed. Then I will come down again. If you look that, then you can do. Very good intelligence. That is not intelligence. We have to take the speediest process. That is intelligence. Yes, he is liking to serve means that is the action of the spiritual body. Therefore, if you actually always remain in spiritual understanding, that means to understand Krishna or God. Then Krishna says, if you have understood what is God, that makes you qualified to go back to home, back to God. Janma karma says, me dibbam, jujanati tattva. If you know what is God, actually, then that is your qualification to go back to home, back to God. But if you do not know, then your spiritual life has not begun. You must know what is God. That is knowledge. Bhavanam janmanam ante jnanamahan maang prapadyam vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudurla. The spiritual life means to understand yourself and understand God and understand your relationship with God and act accordingly. That is spiritual life. It is not difficult. How to understand God? You can understand just like you understand so many things from books. So there is a book. God is explaining Himself. I am like this. So you understand Him. Then you become qualified. Yes.
What is that? He's quoted speaking about the verse, out of millions of men who try for the path, only one may know me. And out of those who know me, only very few know me in truth.
That is stated in Bhagavad Gita also. Manushyanam sahasreshu kaschid yatati siddhaye yatatam api siddhyanam kaschid vetimam tatata. Where is Bhagavad Gita? Find out this verse. Manushyanam sahasreshu. Out of many millions of men, the human life is meant for understanding God. He can understand. But the attempt is not there. They are after sense gratification. Nobody is interested to understand God. Everybody is interested in cats and dogs business. Sense gratification. Therefore, out of many millions of men, one can understand that my life is meant for other purpose. That is called siddhi, perfection. How I shall make my life perfect? This desire arises in one man out of millions. They are simply engaged how to satisfy senses perfectly. That will never be done. So a sane man thinks that I have done it so many lives, I have not been satisfied, I have not become perfection. Then what is perfection? That inquisitiveness makes him eligible. Just like Adau Shuddha, I have already explained. So after becoming siddha, perfect, perfect means one must know that I am not this body. I am soul, aham brahman. That is perfection of knowledge. So Krishna says, yatatam api siddhanam. Those who have become perfect, out of many millions of them, one can understand what I am. It is not so easy to understand God. But if you take the process as it is recommended in these shastras by saintly person, then it is easy. Otherwise it is not easy. If you speculate to understand God, that is not possible. Then you go on for many, many years speculating. You never understand. Either you take the shelter of Lord Jesus Christ or Krishna, if you follow His instruction, this is the way of understanding, then you'll understand. But if you don't care for His instruction, then you'll never understand. This is the problem.
Yes.
Those who are going to Vaikuntha planets, they are not fully realized of God? What does he say?
He is citing the instance of the four Kumaras who were traveling through the gates of the Vaikuntha world, but actually they were not completely God-realized.
Therefore they are on the gates of Vaikuntha, not within. You cannot enter the kingdom of God without full understanding. So you have to be trained up. This is the life. You become trained up to understand God and you will enter the kingdom.
How does one associate with the devotees?
You do not understand? You can come and live with these devotees? Where is the difficulty? You can live here, you can take prasadam, and without any charge, still you are asking? This is the way. Adho saddha tato sadhu sangha. You have to make your association with the devotee. Then you learn. Sadhu Sangha means you have to give up the association of non-devotees. This question was asked to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by a devotee. He was householder. So he inquired, "My dear sir, what is the real standard of behavior of a devotee?" He immediately answered, that asasanga tagi vaishnavas. Vaishnava, devotee, his first behavior is he should give up unwanted association. That is first. Now the next question will be, what is that unwanted association? He answered, asaktakstrisangi krishna bhaktava. This unwanted association means people who are too much attached to sex life, they are unwanted. And the another non-devotee of God, they are unwanted. So you be careful not to mix with these people and come to the devotional service, then your life will be better. Initiation is the third stage. First stage is that just like you have come, this is called Shraddha, faith, little faith, not full faith. Then you have to increase this faith by association of devotees. That is required. And when the faith is increased, then the question of initiation. Initiation should not be immediately offered. That will be misused. Therefore, when we initiate, we inquire from the head of the temple how long he is coming, what is his behavior. If he certifies that yes, he is doing nice, then we initiate. Our initiation is not so cheap. You come and may initiate me. No, we do not do that. We must test him. First of all. Then you initiate.
His question was that, can you take initiation by accepting the spiritual master in your heart without actually taking...
These are bogus propositions. It has no meaning. It has no meaning. If you think within yourself, I am eating, will you be satisfied? You starve and simply think, I have eaten everything. Is that a very practical proposal? You must eat. We don't say all these bogus propositions. Thank you very much.